Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Mitchell Gymnasium. As we're broadcasting live from Lennoxville, Quebec, we have the McGill Martlets taking on the home team, the Bishop's Gaiters. I'm Jeff Ritnell, soon to be joined by Sean Naylor, and he'll be by to do the color commentating for this game. Game started off, our apologies for starting off a little late, as well as we'll catch you up with some scoring here as the Gaiters actually have back-to-back threes to start off the game. Full court press there by Jesse Waugh. The McGill Martlets struggle to get it over half. A missed shot right away by the Martlets, and they're struggling to put points up on the board in the first 2 minutes. Have an inbound here for McGill. Jesse Waugh takes the picks it off, sorry, as it slipped out of number six's hand for McGill. Missed layup there by Waugh, and that was Enithim Lazarenko who missed that inbound pass there and wound up in Waugh's hands. And we're now joined by Sean Naylor of the men's football team. And it's been raining three so far here tonight, as that was number 14 for the Martlets. Marie-Ève Martin with the three. Brings the score now to 6-3 Gaiters. Gaiters are going to need to win all of their games if they want to make the playoffs. Right now they sit two back of Laval. Cathy Germain passes it out to Waugh. Back over to Oulette Gauchard. She tosses up. And that does not go. That was poor clock management there by the Gaiters. But luckily off of the hands of Helene Bibeau of the Martlets, that will be Gaiters ball. No, my apologies, sorry. That will be a McGill ball. No. Bishop's ball, my apologies. Three times. Chamberlain tosses up another three.
Draining that deep three, number eight. Gabrielle Chamberlain.
Bibeau has it for McGill to Martin. Martin misses the three. Recovered there by Waugh.
Jesse's bringing up the ball. She's calling the play. She's...
It's Trafford under the net there, and she's stuck. It will be off of her arm and out. It will be McGill ball. Riley Shkimba and Anik Sharl now into the game for the Gaiters.
Is it back?
Woo! Beautiful little fake there by Chamberlain. Unfortunately, off the front of the rim and out. Over to the far side, number eight, Francois Charest has it for the Gaiters back, for the McGill Martlets. Hard D there by Bailey Trafford as she stops number six of McGill, and it's him, Lazarenko. However, the second time that ball came down, Trafford was forced to foul there.
Foul on it, Charles, number 14. Seems that she's playing the point right now with Jesse Waugh number 10. It's quite the tandem they have there. Shot by number 14.
Another three tossed up there by Marie-Ève Martin.
Woo! Inside out for the...
Chamberlain
has
it out.
She's sitting there for the... There it is, dishing it out for the shot. Easy shot.
Good hustle there by Annette Sharrow, but unfortunately unable to pick up the ball. That was Roya Asadi who took over for McGill. Good little give and go down low. No shot, but it will be a foul on number 8, Gabrielle Chamberlain of the Gaiters. It's a 9-3 game for Bishops.
Class of 1-8, Gabrielle Chamberlain, substitution in on the court for Catherine Blanchet-Paquette.
Mrs. Paquette's stepping on the court. She brings a lot to the game. She's quite athletic for her size. Seems that she plays the number 3 position.
Pull-up jumper, and it's good. That's Francoise Charré with a beautiful little pull-up jumper. As Wall now carries up the ball for the Gaiters. Annette Charles over to the far side to Paquette. Longe Paquette back to Charles. Charles drives to the net, back out to Shkimba. Shkimba drains the jumper.
What a crisp shot by number 12. Nothing but net on that one there.
Full court press on here once again by the Gaiters as McGill struggles to get it over the half. They just make it. Ball down low to him, Lazarenko. Back out to the perimeter. Blocked there by a great hustle there by Jesse Waugh. The shot clock is ticking down. A miss there by him, Lazarenko. Did not touch the rim, and that will be a turnover for the Martlets. That's a Gaiters ball.
Seems like Bishop's trying to keep the high pressure to get this game over and done with real early here. Playing a full court press right from the get.
Will be Wall carrying up the ball for the Gaiters. Back over to Shao.
Ooh, nasty cross.
Nothing there as the ball works its way back out to the perimeter. Wall to the far side. Picked off
by Jesse, and turnover again. Stolen by Jesse.
Waugh misses a contested layup. That will be Charré dribbling up the floor, but picked off by Waugh. That's her second steal in a minute. Back over to Charles. Charles dribbles down.
Woo! You're looking at the most athletic girl in Canada right now. Number 14. Just greasy to the net.
A foul called there on Annick Shaw. It's called for a block, an illegal pick, actually. Him Lazarenko leads the team with averaging 15.2 points a game there for McGill. Beautiful defense there by Catherine Boulanger-Paquette as she reached out just to tip that pass out of bounds. Good D here for the Gaiters as they stretch the lead 13-5 with 3:13 left in the first quarter. Nothing but net there as the long jumper there by him, Lazarenko. She shows her range as well as having great size. She checks in at 5'10", and she's drained a long two. Claire Murphy now into the game for the Gaiters. Back over to Germain. Down low to Trafford. Trafford fights against him, Lazarenko, but good defense keeps that ball out of the rim. Charré now has it for McGill. Back over to Grout Brown as she misses that shot and rebounded by Caddy Germain. Boulanger-Paquette has it now for the Gaiters. Pulls up in the corner. Trafford's working down low. A long little layup there and drains it for two.
What's by Trafford? Baby Trafford just showing it how it's done in the paint.
Grout Brown has it for McGill. Back over to Charré. Back over to him, Lazarenko. Out to the point. Roya Sande pulls up for one-handed hook shot. A foul called there against Roya Sande as she was unable to get into the lane. 2 minutes left on the clock, 15-7 for the Gaiters. McGill leads the conference with a record of 11-1. Only one loss on the season. Gaiters look to upset the top-ranked team in Quebec right now. Murphy out to the outside to Boulanger-Paquette, and that's a good for three.
Paquette just draining a deep three like that. Come on. Off the hop. Off the hop.
We've seen great perimeter work here by the Gaiters early. Charest drives and picks right through the entire Gator team, and she lays it up in easy two. Up to the outside. Ooh, that got Charest out to Murphy. Murphy misses the three. Foul called against Dana Janvier down low, and that will be a McGill ball.
Leading
the you're straight veteran at this, huh?
The out to the outside for McGill. Once again, the full court pressure being applied by the Gaiters, and it seems to have confused the McGill Martlets so far. As that Charest pulls up for a quick jumper. Called out of bounds there as that was number 21. Bebo stepped on the line.
Great defensive play there by Bishops again. Seeming like they want to stick it to McGill early.
Wall carries it up for the Gaiters. Over to Godchild. She drains a big three. It's a 21-9 lead.
Oh, deep three. And so where has this Bishops been all year? You got to ask the question. They're just snapping.
McGill has it out at the top. Foul called against Caddy Germain, and it seems to be so far in this quarter with only 25 seconds left. The refs seem to be calling a lot of minor fouls tonight, Sean.
I do. I'm kind of concerned with that because a lot of the top players have seemed like they're going to be getting out pretty early. We may not see them play as much as early. I mean, Anika's already has two. Anika Charles has two. We got another foul for something that seems like they're just playing aggressive defense. You almost want to ask the refs, just let the girls play, you know?
Will be number 9, Francois Grote Brown. Pulls up and hits her first of two. Pulls up for her second. She's 2 for 2.
Substitution on the court number 4, Catherine Paquette. Substitution for number 10, Jessie Wong.
The outside is Chamberlain.
Looks like they're looking the perimeter game.
Caddy Germain, a couple of pump fakes there. Pulled to the outside, an open three there. And drained again. It's Catherine Boulanger-Paquette with another three.
It seems like they're just putting a two over here with this two ball late like that.
So far the Gaiters are 6 for 7 from the three-point line. Just a blistering percentage.
You say somebody's hot because I'm pretty sure somebody's hot right now.
Some stats from the first half here. Scoring's pretty spread out for the Gaiters as Boulanger-Paquette, Chamberlain, as well as Ouellette Godchild all have 6 points on the night. For McGill, you're looking at Francois Charest with 4 points on the night. The end of the first quarter ticks down, and we're working our way into the second quarter. It's good to be joined by my partner, Sean Naylor. He's a last-minute replacement and done a fine job so far. Thank you for joining us here live on SSN Canada, coming to you from the Mitchell Gymnasium. interesting fact, Sean, actually. The coach for McGill is one of the only players, is actually a remaining player. Ryan Thorne played for the Gaiters. He's in his ninth season of coaching, and he actually took home one of the championships with the Gaiters. Their only CIS championship came as Ryan Thorne was on the team. And you see him now as an experienced coach in the CIS. Seconds tick down here in the quarter timeout. .24-11 lead for the Gaiters as the players get back out onto the court. On the court for the Gaiters, we have Wah, Janvier, Chamberlain, Oulette Gachard, as well as Caddy Germain. Prout Brown drives to the outside, back out to Martin. Out to the outside to Bibeau. Bibeau goes up for two. And a great rebound there by Chamberlain. And Sean, it's definitely been the issue for the Gaiters have been turnovers and rebounds so far in the season.
And it seems like right now that they're taking care of that. They seem to be taking care of that. That's a pretty hard foul there. I guess they're going to have to call that one.
It was accidental, I believe, but both. That was number 14, Marie-Ève Martin, went down pretty hard for McGill.
But I do have to agree with you. It seems that they've been having troubles with rebounding and turnovers this year. And it's right now, early on, it seems that they've taken care of the rebounding and the turnover and creating turnovers.
We have a foul call there again on Chamberlain. It's her second foul on the night. Annette Charles has two fouls on the night so far. McGill doing quite well at not fouling so far. With only one foul so far in the game, and we're a minute into the second quarter. Chamberlain with another rebound for the Gaiters. She's looked to be on fire so far tonight. Wobb crosses up a 2-3, and another big three for the Gaiters.
This perimeter game is just unbelievable tonight. I think it's almost unheard of. I've never seen it like this here before.
It's now 7-for-8 on the night from three-point land. This Gaiters team has really lacked that perimeter shooting so far in the season, and they've definitely improved on it as they show it tonight. A near buzzer shot clock beater there by number 21, Bibeau. Wall dribbles in for the Gaiters. Bobble there by Chamberlain. She recovers. Double dribble call against Chamberlain. Good defense by number 9, Frances Grout Brown, to force that double dribble.
It seems once again, coach of Bishop's Alex is calling on his super athletes again, number 14, Annette Godcharles, and number 4, Mrs. Paquette.
Francoise Charret out to the outside. To Laroc, back to the outside to Charret. Charret really controlling the ball here for McGill. Ball back out to Saadi. Saadi drains a three.
Ooh. That's a pretty deep three I've seen right there. It seems like both teams today are trying to work that perimeter game. Haven't seen much driving. Why bother stopping if you're hitting those shots, eh?
And a pull-up jumper there by Wall with a beautiful little nothing-but-net jumper for two. Ball back to the outside as that's Martin. Martin over to number 11, Asandi. Back out to Charret. Charret misses the three. That is a Gaiters ball as that's a foul. An over-the-back foul. Number 6, Enith Him Lazarenko.
That's a tough name to say. Say that a couple of times there. I'm finally getting a call going the other way there. Seemed a bit rare, but hey, that's the way it goes in the dice.
Riley Shikimba passes it over to Wallace. She brings the ball up the court. Back out to Trafford, to Chamberlain. Back over to Waugh.
Woo! A dirty cross! Oh my, get out of here with that!
That is Jesse Waugh breaking ankles going to the rim with that one. This is a Gators team. We haven't seen much of this here. Lots of energy, lots of scoring, even rebounding. It's great to see such a young team improving over the course of the season, Sean.
It is. It's kind of refreshing to see that. It's like finally the basket's finishing and it's going in the net now. And they're making they're creating their turnovers. It seems like they're doing their job this time and not somebody else's job.
Oh, Gabrielle Chamberlain, a hard landing there. She put everything she could to get that rebound. Unfortunately, did not come up with it. That's him, Lazarenko, that has the ball for McGill. Back out to Francoise Charest. She's setting up the play that she wants. Shot clock ticking down, and that's a turnover. And Stephanie Annette Sharrell steals it. Back over to Chamberlain to Shkimba. Shkimba misses that quick little layup. Definitely a layup you'd like to have. Maybe she felt she had a little more pressure than she did there, Sean.
Yeah, I think so. I think she just needed to be a little more patient. Clearly the other player was out of position.
Pull-up jumper there by Natalie Lacroix. Unable to get it down. And it looks like McGill's trying to keep up with his three-point game and unsuccessful at that right now, Sean.
It's unsuccessful. I think they're playing out of panic all of a sudden. They're the top dogs in the league, and right now they're getting worked, let's be honest here. And when you play out of panic, you tend to make bad decisions. They don't seem relaxed out there as Bishops is playing right now. They play a lot relaxed. They're just shooting their shots when they need to take their shots. They're not really forcing much.
And McGill is still shooting 33%, so not a terrible percentage. Just unable to defend those three-point shots as Gators are shooting 55% on the night. Kick ball there by Marie-Ave Martin. We have a bit of a change here for McGill as Lazarenko is out. Roy Asande is back into the game.
And we have Gabriel Cuetet, who just stepped in right now. Number 23. Oh my, look at that.
And beautiful inbound play as Coach Akawet took it to the rim for two.
Gabriel just stepping in and taking a play like that, eh?
Woo. Number 8, beautiful little dribbling there as of Charest. Beautiful little cross. Down to Roy Asande, and she puts it up for two. Ball over to Shkimba. Shkimba seeing lots more time over the year as the native of Kingston, Ontario is really taking to a bigger role on the team.
Seems to be a reaching call, I think, there on Kathy Germain. Oh, it's a pushing. Sorry about that.
No basket there, and the ball will be inbounded. As we see Chamberlain as well as Watt. Germain, Cote Coet come out of the game for the Gators. Ball out to the perimeter, Francois Charest. Kick ball there called on Waugh. Looked to almost bounce over her foot, but it definitely touched it and will be McGill throwing. Coach Ryan Thorne barking up the orders from the McGill sideline. Ball down low there to Martin. Partan pulls up for a long jumper. No good. And stolen there. Rebounded there by Annette Chow. Interesting little pass back to Waugh. Ball out to the outside. A beautiful little fake there by Charles. Misses the layup. Recovered by McGill. Oh, what a stuff there by Annette Charles.
I think just getting up there,
It's winter outside, and it definitely got a little stuffy inside.
Oh, my.
Winter outside, my apologies. Jumper there, 4-3, no good. Natalie Lacroix still looking to find her shooting on the night. Wall back up to the outside to Chamberlain. Chamberlain with a hard run into there. It was number 22, Valerie Lacoye. Both benches wanted a foul on that one. McGill working the perimeter now. Out to Martin. Martin for three. Still looking for a three ball is McGill.
It just seems like they're not dropping their shots. Looks like they got to take a new tactic at the net there.
Last game McGill played at Bishop's, they came out on fire, shooting incredibly high percentage of threes. Gators look to kind of beat them at their own game on this one. Ball goes out of bounds there, and it will be a Gators throw-in, as Bailey Trafford was the intended recipient on that pass. 3:22 left to play in the second quarter. The timeout there for for the Gators, I believe. 33-18 score. Gators shooting 88% from three-point land so far. 7 for 8.
The Gators' next home game is 1 week Saturday, February 19th, when the Gators will host the Val. Tip-off is at 6 and 8 p.m.
Next game for the Gators will be next weekend as they take on Laval at home. Will be the last broadcast of the SSN season, depending on a comeback in the standings by both Gators teams. But right now it looks like both of them won't make it the playoffs unless they get on fire right by the end of the season.
Have
will be an inbound here for the Gators. Wall has it at the perimeter for the Gators. Back down low with a beautiful little fake. Oh, Zulette Godchar almost drained it. Stolen there by a great second effort by Boulanger Paquette. Over to Chamberlain with a wide open three off the front rim. Gators bench really encouraging the Gators to get back as quick as possible. Foul there by Jean Vier. It was a definite slap. You could almost hear it from up here, Sean.
That you could. That you could.
It's her, him, Lazarenko. It's her first of two. Shooting her second. No good. Battle for the ball will be off of the hands of Ulette Godchild. Definitely did not agree with that call, as it looked to be pretty close from here. Kim Lazarenko has it at the point. Back out to Lacroix. Down low to him, Lazarenko. She puts it up for a difficult hook, too. Long pass to that Godchar. She pulls up for a jumper. An unlucky bounce, and that's no good. Gators have gone a little colder here in the second quarter. Martin drives down low. Well, sorry, that was Laroque who drove down low. Unable to get the shot to drop. Back out to Chamberlain. To Trafford, who's in all sorts of traffic. Trafford's still looking to get her shooting game on tonight.
Yeah, we seem to have lost her a bit of a stroke there. I don't know. They asked us to make that about 10 minutes ago. We're making that every time.
Missed three there by Martin. Wall recovers the ball. It was Boulanger Paquette with the rebound. Blanche Paquette. The outside to let Godchild. Back over to Wah. Wah with a pull-up jumper. Gators really refusing to go to the net, as once again it was a pull-up jumper rather than driving to the net. It is a timeout for McGill. Play left here in the second quarter. Gators really improving on that rebounding, as we mentioned. 14 and 16 out rebounding McGill by two right now, which they haven't done before against a team in quite a long time. 1:30 left to play as the timeout's winding down. Martlets and Gaiters work their way back onto the court. Coach Alex Perno in his third year really taking all that length of the timeout as possible. The referees do not wait, and they let the Martlets inbound it right away. Martin back over to Charret. Wadu, great defense there. Down low to him, Lazarenko. She puts up a difficult two. Now only a 12-point lead for the Gators.
Seems like we just need to get that bucket open up again and start scoring again.
Shots have been there, just unable to hit them. That was a miss there by Blanchet Paquette. Maybe a bit of a heat check, Sean.
Yeah.
Hard contact down there. That's an offensive foul.
Charge.
Wow, that's Chamberlain has just been beaten up underneath the rim. It's about her third hard fall on the night. And she draws the foul.
I think you might have to start wearing helmets after this game. I'm not sure, but my gosh. Maybe it's the momentum they need here. If you need to score a 1-2 basket here before half, it'd be real good.
Therapist Stephen and Nathan King. The father-son combo that run the Bishop's Athletic Therapy will definitely have to go to work tomorrow for the Gators. That's Trapper's quick jumper that puts another two up on the board for the Gators. It's a 35-21 lead. Some more beautiful dribbling.
Freaking nasty cross, I'm sorry. There's a strip. There it is. You got 17 seconds here. Vicious with the ball. Last possession. Seems like they're going to make a pay. Are they going to put the dagger in here? We can almost finish the game right now.
And oh, what a three. Put it on the board. That is another three. McGill decides to run out the clock. That is now a 38-21 lead. And there's definitely an upset watch here at the Mitchell Gymnasium in Lennoxville, Quebec. We'll be back in approximately 15 minutes for your second half coverage.
Let's do it. Support Mission.
And welcome back to the Mitchell Gymnasium here in beautiful Lennoxville, Quebec. I'm joined by my partner, Sean Naylor, and we're about to start the third quarter here as the Gaiters lead 38-21. Thank you for joining us here on SSN Canada. Gaiters start off the half with the ball as Waugh has it. Back over to Germain. Germain, a wide open three, unable to get it. But a foul called as that's another rebound for Chamberlain.
She seems to be taking all the boards here, you know. She's not even our big lady. She's taking all our boards for us.
That's her first personal foul.
It's her first of two. Chamberlain so far is 2 for 5, both coming from the three-point line. She's 2 for 3 on the night. Make that 8 on the night. McGill forced to turn it over. They're unable to get the ball across half. We've seen that all night as they're unable to carry the ball up to half in the time allowed.
It seems like Bishop's really trying to take it to them early. You know,
Woo! That's the Caddy Germain of old, my friends. That is her old. Easy stroke like that. The expected three-point shot, and she cashes in on it.
Almost goes into the crowd trying to force a turnover, but now McGill has it, swinging it around the perimeter. Charest takes it herself back out to Martin. Misses the three. McGill struggled from three-point land all
night.
She is
having a tough time tonight. She's usually easy for 30 burger on us, and she is just not getting it done. I think that's when the coach got to step in and get her out, or get her something out, other way to get her confidence back up.
McGill's been in and out of the top 10 nationally all year. Struggling with boxing out there, but Him Lazarenko does grab the rebound. It will be McGill ball. LaRocque has it. Takes it to the net as a lane opens right up for her.
You know, if I was coaching against us, that's the thing. That's what I would be doing, is just taking it to the key. It seems like we're getting beat on our first step. We got great pressure on the court press. Just taking it right there. 124 going hard at it.
The Gaiters were unable to go to the line at all for three throws in the first half, and right now they've done it twice in the first 2 minutes.
I did find that kind of odd. We did have the first half went by pretty quick, you know. We didn't have any foul shots. I just wondered why it went as fast.
Trafford hits her first of two. Gaiters now 3 for 3 on the night from three-point land. And she hits it to go 4 for 4 from the charity stripe. Foul call there against the Gaiters as they were unable to get back to establish a good defense.
Well, I think that wasn't a foul there. I think he just mistaken the sound of the ball being hit so fervently that he had to call the foul.
And a quick two there by number 21. Number 21, the starter there, Yohlen Bibo. Oh, beautiful little spin there. Woo! What a beautiful layup by Chamberlain.
That was a spin that Baryshnikov would have been proud of.
And a charge called. What outstanding play by Gabrielle Chamberlain. The first cheer out of Sherbrooke's just looking impressive to say the least. We saw her put up 20 at Laval for the Gaiters' first win. We haven't really seen the same Chamberlain yet, and she's showing this form tonight. Trafford over to Annette Schau.
Calling for the ball. Melanie.
Back over to Boulanger-Paquette. Shot clock ticking down. Annette Schau walks right through, and the McGill bench is nothing but upset on that one. I'm not sure if they're angry at their own players or angry at the no foul call, but I certainly did not see a foul there.
I didn't see a foul. I think they were asking for travel, but he only took a two-step and a long jump there.
A quick two there by Francoise Charest. It's a 49-27 lead for the Gaiters with 7 minutes left to go in the quarter. Charles tosses up a three. Woo, it is raining threes tonight.
Oh my gosh. It seems like Bishop is hell-bent on blowing the lid off of this game quick and early, sending the Martlets home in crying heaps.
A quick two there, and the Gaiters are going to need to shut down number eight, Francoise Charest. She's been able to drive right to the net without a problem so far tonight.
I know, she seems to be the one that's just that, the little engine that could.
The charge called there. There's a hard contact as Jesse Wall put a bit of a shoulder into number eight, Francoise Charest. She's all over the floor right now. Gators backing off on the pressure at full court. Kind of surprised the Marauders. The Martlets, my mistake. Back over to him, Lazarenko. Him, Lazarenko goes to the basket and Trafford call for a foul. Moved her feet there to try to make that ball, or that hoop, a little more difficult. Him, Lazarenko going back to the free throw line. Hits her first. Misses her second. Gators boxing out, didn't even realize where the ball was, and it's recovered by McGill. Tosses the quick jumper there. Unable to box out is Jesse Waugh, but missed shot and recovered there by Riley Shkimba. Waugh drives down the floor. Oh, beautiful between the leg bounce pass. Woo!
Looking like a regular highlight reel tonight. If I was recruiting, I would just use this game tape alone of what it's like to play here at Bishops.
Gators definitely showing all their talents here tonight. As Charest has it for the Gators. She's controlled the ball for the majority of the time for McGill. She does drive to the net and force a foul. The Gators are once again in a bit of foul trouble. And right now they have a 24-point lead, and they don't want to let that slip away by taking fouls.
That's your first personal foul of the game.
I know, it kind of seems to have that feeling like maybe this could slip away. Like, we don't want to have that happen. We just got to keep this hot hand that we've got. Keep playing that tough D we're playing, and we'll end up with a W for sure.
Well, Sean, the Gaiters have really struggled to put 50-plus points up all year. Right now we're at 54 with a little over 5 minutes left to play in the third quarter.
That is true, and if we continue to do so, I mean, that's an easy W for us.
It will be Shkimba to inbound the ball. Ball swung over to Trafford. Back over to Murphy down low. Great passing once again. As Germain drives to the net. No foul called there. Rebounded by McGill. Ball up and a missed three by Martin. Mariev Martin. Missed three, and it will be off of the Gators' hands and a McGill throw-in.
She has seemed to have gone for about, I think, she is 0 for 7, I think. To be honest with you, she was 0 for 4 at the half, and she seemed to take the three more, and still no luck with to get that drop to happen.
Three from downtown. Charest once again. Yeah. Ball being swung across the court by the Gaiters. Back over to Murphy. Back down low to Germain. Germain up for a quick two. And this run-and-gun offense is really working here, Sean.
That is. A perimeter offense that we've been having is allowing for us to make lanes happen. Everyone's got to step up because everyone's making those big shots. And doing so, we're just getting those lanes wide open.
Sheree drives to the net. Puts a ball up off the bottom of the net, but fouled there. And she'll go to the line for two. It's Claire Murphy with the foul for the Gaiters. So Shkimba and Murphy check out, as well as Trafford. Sheree to the line. It's her first of two. And this is her second. Janvier out rebounded by Valerie Lecoye. Lecoye had a great game last time McGill visited Bishops. Jambay has it back over to Boulanger-Paquette. Back over to Wah. Wah with a beautiful little fake. That'll be a foul call there against Marie-Ève Martin of McGill. Wah has it now, dribbles down to the basket. Great pass to Jambit. She lays it in for a tricky two. Ball out to the outside. Janvier put a hand in there, unhappy with the call. So will be a throw in here for McGill. Trafford's back in, takes Janvier out. Lecoye up to the line for two. Misses her first. Lecoye, the tallest girl in the game, as she measures in at 6'2". A little taller than both Sean and I. Puts her second up and misses both. Gabrielle Chevron has it now for the Gaiters. Dribbles up the floor. Beautiful pass to Germain. Germain with a beautiful reverse layup for two.
I don't want to say it too soon, but it just seems like Bishop is unstoppable today.
Definitely looked so far, Sean. Sheree goes to the outside to LaRocque. LaRocque back out to Sheree. Sheree puts it up for two and three, and drains it. She's been on fire here in the third quarter.
I know it's a team game and all, but she is just keeping the McGill Redmonds, the Martlets, just that close, you know? She just keeps hitting these threes. As a coach, I keep working on the ball all day.
Definitely been the best player on the court so far for McGill. Ball over to Chamberlain. Back over to Olette Godchild. Down to Wah. Wah stripped of the ball. No foul call, but that will be a Gaiters throw in with 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Wah has it now. Back over to that Godchild, and she drains another three.
She made her pay for that little trip. I'm telling you, she saw it. She took the shot early. She knew she had it. She felt confident. You can see it in the release. Net after that one.
12 points on the night, all coming from three-pointers. If you do the math, that would be 4 3-pointers. Wall recovers. Full court press put on here by McGill. Wall dribbles out of it. Quick pass once again. Trafford has it. It will be a turnover there.
On
1:56 left remaining here in the third quarter. McGill calls for a timeout. It'll be a 60-second timeout. The Gaiters win it, leading 63-41. And Gaiters have still had a spread out night, as it would be 12 points for Oulette Gottschall and 10 for Charmelin, as well as Trafford with 10 to lead it, and 19 from Francoise Charest. She's definitely been on fire all second half. Both teams are in bonus. As the timeout ticks down, players back onto the floor. See if the Gaiters can hold on for the upset. As the last place team right now is leading the first place team. Not by a small margin either. 22 points. Ball inbounded there. So Charest has it for McGill. Back over to Charest. Down low. Stolen by Chamberlain. The reach called there against Laroc. And that will be Chamberlain going to the line for two more. She's 2 for 2 on the night from the charity strip. It's her first of two. This is her second. Off of the hands of the Gaiters, I estimate, not quite sure if correct on that one. Ref did not signal what call he made. 1:30 left here in the third quarter. Ball tossed up by Laroc. She hits a three. And it's now a 20-point game. Chamberlain back over to Trafford. Wall looks for some room. Jumps, pulls up, and a beautiful jumper. Charest tosses it over to Brown Grip. Back over to Charest. Down low to him, Lazarenko. Back to the outside, Lacoye. Sorry, it's not Lacoye, it's Bibeau. Bibeau misses, rebounded there by Trafford. Seconds left to play here. Hard contact with Germain and Charest down low. No foul called. All out to the outside. Shot clock ticking down. A long three. Missed there. Rebounded by Trafford. Beautiful rebound. She tosses up and misses her second there. Coach Ryan Thorne barking out the orders for the last 15 seconds as McGill has possession. Four, three, ball to the outside. A long jumper by Grout Brown, and that's a miss. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. Bishop's Gaiters, 66. And the McGill Martlets, 44. And John, really an impressive end to that third quarter to keep the Gaiters' lead extended.
It's a bit mind-boggling, John. I didn't foresee the game turning out this way. And you know, I'm really pleasantly surprised about the way they're playing. It seems they're not getting frustrated at the little calls that we used to get frustrated at. We seem to be playing. Just for everyone else out there listening, the out-of-town score is UCAM 76, Concordia 66. That's the final score of that game.
And the game's done pretty early. As we have 1 minute left here in the timeout. And Sean, what do the Gaiters need to do to really keep this lead and avoid a massive comeback by McGill?
Well, now they really have to take smart shots. They've got to take the smart shots. They've got to get those defensive rebounds. They've got to slow the game. They got to take it and pace it just a little bit less than what they've been doing. Use that clock as to their advantage. Because right now, what's going to happen is the Marlins are going to come out hard, aggressive. They're going to try and take it to the hoop. They're going to try and shoot lights out, which means they're going to probably make shots they shouldn't try and take. So in that, they got to just play patient and play sound basketball. They got to get that ball. They got to move it up the court with purpose, but not too fast. And just keep it that way, and then come out with the W.
Perfect. We have some stats coming in here at the end of the third quarter. Gaiters have dropped off to 65% from the three-point line, but still.
That's pretty impressive, I'll tell you.
Consider it dropped from 88. It's definitely been a great night for the Gaiters as they've been 11 for 17 from the three-point line. That's a passing grade if I've ever seen one.
It seems like Coach has been saving his athletic ladies for the end for defensive struggle. He's brought in number 14, Anna Guy Charles, and Mrs. Puckett, number four.
Catherine Ballanger.
Ooh, a little bit of floor burn there as you could hear the scrape all the way up here in the broadcast booth. It was number 21, Helene Bibeau, went to the floor for McGill. It will be Charest, who I don't think I've seen somebody control the ball from one team as much as Charest has tonight.
Well, in a struggle, you hope that you have somebody that's going to step up and show some kind of light in a game like this, you know? You don't ever say you concede a loss or you take a loss, but you want to make sure there's somebody out there who's always willing to fight even when things go down, when the chips aren't going your way.
It's number four. Catherine Boulanger-Paquette with a foul called against her. Only Gator in real foul trouble would be Dana Jambe, who's already had four, and you've seen her take a seat on the bench for that, and Bailey Trapp really bump up her playing time. And Lazarenko has it for McGill. Dribbles to the rim, an impressive off-balance layup there for two. And a travel call against Jesse Waugh. This is not the start that the Gators wanted, Sean.
This is not what we asked for. We told them to get the rebound. We wanted them to get the rebounds and control the pace of the game. And right now they're playing right in the Marlins. You can't let them get momentum. Basketball is a game of momentum, and it's controlling those swings.
Him Lazarenko dressing. And an offensive foul called.
That's what we're looking for. Let's swing that momentum into our favor here. Let's go now. Let's go. Let's go, girls. Let's go.
Boulanger-Paquette spotted the lane that him Lazarenko is trying to get into and took a beautiful offensive foul.
Offensive foul charge for McGill, number 6, and that's him, Lazarenko. Her second personal, first team foul of the quarter.
That's McGill's first team foul of the quarter, which is just a crazy stat.
That was quite the air ball there, I'm not going to lie.
It'll be a throw in here for Oulette Gachau. Ball has it down low to Trafford. Back out to Charles. Charles misses a layup. Difficult layup. She had time to pull up, but definitely looked to try to draw a foul instead.
I think that's what her whole idea was, just to draw the foul and get them into foul trouble. That way they can't play aggressive defense. I could see Coach doing something like that.
Let Godchild back to Trafford. Trafford takes the inbounds. Passes it over to Waugh. A nice little fake and bake. All beautiful pass out to the outside for Waugh. Waugh misses a three, and she's got a little bit cold here in the fourth quarter. Ball toss up there by LaRock in the miss, but another rebound by McGill. LaRock drives to the net. A foul call there, and that's going to be, I believe, Stephanie Annette Charles' fourth. And it is. Well, that's another Gator who's in foul trouble. This Caddy Germain looks to replace her, and Annette Charles will definitely take a seat on the bench to not avoid getting fouled out. First free throw is missed.
They just seem to not be getting that bucket down, or do they?
LaRock's definitely struggled tonight so far. She hits her second there. It was 1-for-2. Waugh has it now. She's in a fierce battle, but passes out of it to Legachow. Back over to Waugh. Here's going to want to kill some time here. Oh, back over to Germain. Germain out to the outside to let Godchild. Difficult three. Misses. Germain passes it back out to let Godchild. She's in a little bit of trouble.
Quite pass a better move. She could have easily taken that to the paint, and she's just deciding, like, you know, let's hold on the ball and juice the clock.
Oh, the opposite of a shooter's bounce there is basket was fighting the ball, and the basket won on that one. Beautiful little dribble there by number 11, Roya Asadi. Chamberlain checks back in the game for the Gators.
McGill foul charge number 14, Mary of Martin. That's her second personal, second team foul.
Oh, beautiful little fake, almost picked off by LaRock. Caddy Germain drives to the hoop. Backs off. Difficult pass to that Godchild. Back over to Waugh. Down low to Trafford. Trafford tosses up. And a beautiful jumper for two.
That's what we needed. There we go.
7 minutes to play in the game. It's 68-49 for the Gators. Mariev Martin with a difficult layup. 4-2. Waugh carries it up. Going to struggle to make half as Mariev Martin makes a beautiful defensive play. Waugh dribbles out of it. Ball ends up on the far side. Passed back to Waugh. To the outside. To Germain. Germain tosses up a three and drains it.
I'm not going to say, but I think that just iced the game there. Yeah, it look like it's
a little Chuck Schwartowski. Pull out the salami and cheese comment there, Sean.
I think so. That's just ridiculous. That is the Kathy I know. She just is just daggering those shots from deep out there.
She has struggled this year, but showing her old form, a little bit of her old form here tonight. That's a quick three in response by Mariev Martin of McGill.
Mariev Martin, that's her first. I think she's gone 1-for-10 tonight, and that's not even a joke.
McGill has it now, down into the hands of him, Lazarenko. Foul called against Bailey Trafford. She's got to stay out of foul trouble as the only other center for the Gators, Dana Jambier, is already close to being fouled out.
Gators foul charge to number 24, Bailey Trafford. That's her second personal, the fourth team foul of the quarter.
Well, my apologies, that's only her second foul. Foul called there. Not a smart play by the Gators. Is a bit of a lazy play to lead to that foul.
Gators foul number 5, Kathy Germain. That's her third personal, 15 foul court. As the Lions shooting the bonus number 5.
Still 5 minutes left. Lots of basketball.
She was 1-for-2 from the line. It's now 71-56 ball game. Two fouls called on the play. We'll see what happens here. It's a foul called there against Brown. Grail Brown, sorry, of McGill. That got Charles in trouble. It's a full court press and a half put on here by McGill. Gaiters, your man with the contested three, and she hits it.
Count it. Count it. I'd say she's heating up, but she's been hot all game, so I haven't had been able to say that.
5 minutes left to play in the game. McGill resorting to the threes. Gaiters having trouble rebounding.
Board. They got to get that board.
Wide open. Bailey Trafford puts it in for two. Great pass there by Annette Charles. That's a timeout by McGill. This game's getting a little out of hand for McGill. As we enter this. As 60 seconds get put on the timeout clock. 4:35 left to play in the game. 76-56 for the Gaiters. As we mentioned before, the Gaiters' next game comes next weekend as they take on Laval at home here in their last home game. It will be Seniors Night, so make sure you tune into that as we see the seniors leaving the team. We'll be congratulated and featured before the game. The timeout ticks down. And Sean, what do you think the Gaiters really have to focus on right now? As it's a 20-point game with 4:35 left.
Well, there's still 5 minutes left. And, you know, what's happening right now is it seems that McGill keeps coming up with the ball after their offensive shots. We can't let them have first and second and third possessions. And, you know, if we keep this game to a single possession, each shot, then we're going to end out right on top here in a 20-point game. And we're going to finish with an impact. And, you know, Bishop's needs to keep doing this in order to go into off the playoffs. If you come off this hot, you just it's anybody's game once the playoffs come.
The Val has to lose out, and the Gaiters have to win the remaining games. Jump ball here is good hustle by Stephanie Annette Charles, and if you ask anybody on this Bishop's team, that's what she's known for.
That's it.
Well, the Rock to toss it in here. It is Grout Brown controlling it for McGill. Stolen by Caddy Germain. Ball up for Oulette Godchild. She misses the three. Back out to Charles. Over to Oulette Godchild. Back over to Germain. Back over to the far side to Chamberlain. To the far side to Charles. And it Charles tosses up a difficult layup, and it's no good.
I think she rolled her ankle on that one, to be honest with you. She's trying to do too much.
Trafford steals it as some poor passing by McGill. Leads to another turnover. Long pass by Annette Charles.
The ball. You see Coach Alex just stepping up there telling his team that he should just slow it down. And then win this game out just by possessions.
Miss layup there by Trafford. An offensive foul called, possibly?
It's a blocking foul, actually, surprisingly. I think the body position of Enick was not in. I think that might be her fifth.
I believe she is now fouled out of the game.
Gators foul charge number 14, Enick Stephanie Charles. That's her fifth personal foul.
She puts on her warm-ups. She'll take a seat on the bench for the remaining 3:14. Jesse Wobb. First one hit there by Francoise Charest. Ball inbounded to Boulanger-Paquette. Over to Germain. Back to Boulanger-Paquette. Three minutes left in the game. Waugh has the ball in a little bit of trouble. Poor pass there by Caddy Germain. Goes into the crowd as that's a lucky souvenir for a fan. LaRocque has it now for McGill. Down low to Lacoye. We see Abina Ado as well. Now into the game, seeing her first time of the night. Jesse Waugh puts up a long two. Now a 78-60 lead. Asadi back over to LaRocque, to Lacoye, to the outside of the Soye, back over to Charest. She misses a three. Loose ball there. There's a few fouls could have been called on that play. Long three missed. Poor blocking out by the Gaiters. Leads to a missed shot. Then off the foot of Natalie LaRocque will be a Gaiters ball. 1:45 left to play. 78-60 game.
Substitution on the court. Bishops number 15, Dan Jean Gay. And number 12, Riley Shakimbo. Bishops basketball.
Belanger Paquette carries it over half. Far side to Waugh. Down low. No shot, but it will be off the hands of McGill, and it will be Gators throwing. 14 seconds left on the shot clock. Wallace had an easy three, but a smart no shot there. She carries it right to the hole. No bucket there. Oh, a beautiful block.
It seems like all ball, but you know, the refs, I think, just trying to make this game a little more interesting.
Definitely looked to be a clean block, but referee saw something different. She hits her first of two. And her second. Wall forces the ball over half. Janvier pulls up for a quick two and misses. Gators are going to need to slow the ball game down. They know this game's pretty much done, but there's no point of letting McGill have the ball back.
That's what I've been trying to say. They've been dominating this game from the get. McGill has not been shooting well all night.
Great hustle underneath by Adu. Missed by Charest. Ball out as Abina Adodo definitely stepped out of bounds as she tried to save the ball. Wall carries up the ball. 45 seconds left to play here. May has it down low. Germain has the ball low. Swings it back out to Wall. Wall drains another three. No let up here in the Gators tonight, Sean.
No quit. They are trying to pour it on. I think they've had enough of being poured on by themselves this season. Had a couple of bad games this year, and it's time to turn the tables a little bit.
Back to a 20-point ball game. 19-point ball game, as it's an 81-62 score. Danielle has it now to a doo-doo. Dudu called for a travel. It will be 17 seconds left on the clock. Gators ball. Look for the shot clock to tick down here. No shot clock. Look for the clock to tick down here. As the Gators rise to their feet. 3, 2, 1. And that's the final. Your Bishop Skaters take home their third win of the season. And Mr. Scorer, you can put another win in the win column for the Gaiters. Final score, 81-62 for Bishops. And Sean, any final reaction to the game at all?
You know what, I don't have much to say. I really enjoyed the fact that they came out and played with a sense of urgency right from the game. They didn't want to lose, they wanted to win. They made it happen.
And what a shared effort by the Gaiters. As they put up, Trafford put up 14 to lead. Then 13 by Germain. 12 by Waugh and Oulette Godshaw. Following out is Gabrielle Chamberlain with 11. Leading the McGill and Martlets for losing causes, 21 points for Francoise Charette. And that wraps up this game. We hope that you join us here in a half an hour as the Gaiters men take on the McGill Redmen. And that will take place in about a half an hour. And we hope that you join us back here on SSN Canada. Signing off for Sean Naylor, I'm Jeff Brittle. See you in 30.